We are at James Weber's studio, and we are putting together a photo shoot. We have three girls, three separate looks. We're doing a period look, kind of rock and roll Elizabethan. We're doing a modern take on mahogany. Then we're doing a natural look.
But I do have a lot of my clients will spend the time setting or using a curling iron or, you know, going the extra distance to create a certain look for themselves because they are in New York City and they do have images to uphold. You can't be afraid. You know, I've worked for John Delaria, who is probably one of the best hairstylists in the industry, in my opinion. And, you know, the one thing that I stuck in my head, I mean, he always just said, you know, be experimental, do not be afraid. Play with wigs. I mean, you know, flip wigs around, you know, chop them up. I mean, set them. You know, I think if you limit yourself to one thing, you're setting yourself up to fail, basically. And, you know, the minute you become afraid, you lose it. You have to have fun. I mean, you have to believe in what you do, too, so.
Anyone can sit there and say, okay, well, wow, great use of color.
Yeah.
But if it looks like it's on a flat face, how is that helping you at all? Basically, my first priority is just get everything kind of sculpted the way I want and then come in and add the color.
Obviously, you have a dear friend that you're working close mm-hmm. with, Christopher Naselli. So how do you guys meet together?
We met 9.5 years ago on a photo shoot. Maybe 10.5, I don't know, I stopped counting. And we hit it off amazingly well. We noticed that we work off of each other instead of working against each other. And that's another thing that you'll notice. A lot of photo shoots, you have the makeup artist who wants to showboat, and then you have the hairstylist who wants to showboat. But if you're all spinning in your own little worlds, you're just gonna bump off of each other.
I just kind of had this inspiration that I wanted to create something that was very structured and very kind of geometrically shaped, and wanted something very, very tight curl. So I, you know, found a wig that I liked, a color that I liked, and then just reset it, rewrapped it, and then just put it on top of a head and just started cutting. Like, cut the fringe really, really short, and just created tons of volume on top and in the back, just very, almost mullet-y.
In order to get started here in New York City, I mean, what does it take?
It's going to take a lot of perseverance, a lot of networking. You're going to be doing a lot of photo shoots where you're not going to be getting paid. Favorite part of Make Bars Television, where you get these little cheats, where you go like, I never even thought of that. That's awesome. I'm gonna steal that.